Hello and welcome to this video addressing key 802.11be transmitter measurements with Keysight's PathWave Vector Signal Analysis software, also known as the 89600 VSA. 802.11be, also known as Wi-Fi 7 or extremely high throughput, is the next generation wireless LAN building on 802.11ax. Main objectives are maximum throughput of at least 30 gigabits per second per access point, carrier frequency operation in 2.4, 5, and 6 gigahertz bands while ensuring backwards compatibility and coexistence with legacy Wi-Fi compliant devices. To meet the need for extremely high throughput, new and enhanced physical layer features are introduced. Compared to 802.11ax, these features include 320 megahertz contiguous bandwidth, doubling the peak throughput, 4096 QAM modulation, enabling a 20% increase in data rates, enhanced OFDMA, allowing multiple resource unit assignments to a single station, making the resources more flexible and efficient. Finally, up to 16 spatial streams, doubling spectral efficiency. The combination of these features provide a maximum theoretical data rate of 46 gigabits per second. For RF measurements, the impacts of these features are much higher than previous generation Wi-Fi. One of the key RF measurement challenge is signal quality measurement of high order modulation formats over a wide bandwidth. Error vector magnitude, or EVM, is a key metric used to evaluate the signal quality of a transmitter. Wider bandwidth systems contribute to higher EVM as they have more integrated noise and more variation in flatness and linearity. With higher order modulation formats, the spacing between the constellation points become much smaller, making the system more sensitive to impairments. So it requires a more stringent EVM performance, and the IEEE standard has a transmitter EVM specification of minus 38 dB for the 496 QAM. To minimize measurement error, test equipment must have a much lower EVM floor. To overcome this, Keysight provides a high-performance signal generation and analysis solutions. For this demo, I will use Keysight Signal Studio software for waveform creation and the 89600 VSA software for signal analysis. These software are used with Keysight Signal Generator and Signal Analyzer platforms. Starting off with Signal Studio, using a 7 GHz center frequency and multi-user PPDU frame structure with 320 megahertz bandwidth. The multi-user PPDU is used for both single-user and multi-user transmission. Single-user is also known as compression mode, where all the resource units are assigned to a single station. Multiple-user transmission can be configured by turning off the compression mode. For this demo, single-user transmission is used. We will use MCS 13 for the highest modulation format for 4096 QAM. Let's now analyze the signal using the 89600 VSA software. Here we can see the spectrum at 7 GHz frequency. I'll go to the wireless LAN application and select 320 MHz 802.11be signal. It is the multi-user PPDU, a single-user transmission. The VSA decodes the SIG field in the preamble and demodulates the signal automatically. No further setting is required. You can see the 4096 QAM in the constellation diagram. Here is the error summary showing EVM and other error metrics. As mentioned earlier, the EVM limit for the 4096 QAM is minus 38 dB. We are measuring minus 50 dB, resulting a 12 dB margin. This high of a margin gives you the confidence in what's being measured is the true performance of the device under test and not of the test equipment. The multi-user info table provides a per-user performance results. In this case, there is only a single user. Lastly, the SIG info providing all the information carried on the different SIG fields. For equalization and tracking, all the default settings are as defined by the IEEE standard. For example, the equalizer is trained using the preamble only. If preamble, pilot, and data are used for equalization, it will further improve the EVM results. The equalization does not compensate for nonlinear errors. VSA provides measurements such as error vector spectrum and error vector time to help troubleshoot any problem in the transmitted signal. Coupling markers across the different traces is very useful to track errors in multiple domains, and the marker values are shown in the marker window. Let's move on to a quick uplink demo, which is trigger-based PPDU. In this example, a single station is assigned a resource of 106 plus 26 tones, and the rest of the channel is occupied by other stations. This means the interference level outside of the transmitted resource must be kept at a minimum. The resource unit info table provides EVM and power of the transmitted resources. In this case, it's MRU number one. Power and EVM for the unused tones are measured. In addition, the VSA provides in-band emissions trace. The emissions trace corresponds to the unused tone EVM and limits column in this table. The yellow is the unused tone EVM, and the red is the limits defined by the IEEE standard. This allows you to easily evaluate the uplink signal quality. In addition to modulation quality measurements, the IEEE 802.11 specification has spectral emissions mask or SEM requirements. It is mainly a measure of interference within the Wi-Fi band. The 89600 VSA provides this measurement with a quick setup for 802.11be. Here you can see the spectrum with the SEM limit mask. The carrier info table provides the carrier power and the power spectral density results. For each offset, the SEM power table returns the measured absolute and relative power. The delta of the measured power from limits defined by IEEE standard and pass-fail results based on the limits. In summary, the 89600 VSA software provides a comprehensive set of tools for demodulation and signal analysis. These tools enable you to measure and troubleshoot your 802.11be chipset components and devices with confidence. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at these websites.